broadband communication provider for this great aviation event. To introduce to you three-time National Aerobatic Champion, six-time member of the U.S. Aerobatic Team, six-time winner of the Benny Scott's First Lady of Aerobatics Trophy, an inductee in the International Aviation Hall of Fame and the International Aerobatic Club Hall of Fame, this is Miss Alaska! This lady will tear up the skies in her Extra 300. Her first aircraft, the one that she won the National Aerobatic Championships, was a Goodrich Extra 260. And it hangs in the Smithsonian's National Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C., where its closest neighbor is the Lockheed Vega, flown by Amelia Earhart.
Notice up there in midfield, you see a ribbon suspended about 18 feet above the runway. That's going to become rather significant here later in the event. That is based in St. Augustine, Florida. He is a member of the Motion Picture Association.
She's worked on a number of film and commercial projects, and you can even fly her famous aircraft, a Microsoft Flight Simulator. As Green goes by, we can wave at him. He can't hear us, but he's got that B-33 sitting there.
Side is up, the green side is down.
brings it right back to Air Show Center. Patty wears a national parachute that provides her with the best safety equipment in the business. CJ Aviation, it makes possible to pump all that wonderful smoke during her operation. And CJ said she'd like to thank Lord Engine Mounts for keeping that engine attached to her aircraft. And of course, Oregon Aero, who makes her ride with the most comfortable pilot comfort accessories. Wheeland Engineering, you know, to Japan when she was only 9 years old, with her father, was a captain for Japan Airlines. And her earliest memories, remember her sitting with her father in the airplane. At 10 years old, her father let her take the controls of a DC-6, and her lifelong love affair with aviation began. From Japan, her travels took her across Southeast Asia, to Europe, and to Australia, where she lived and traveled up the west coast of Australia in a small boat. In 1979, she moved to Alaska, a small town in the southwest part of the state. She worked for Bristol Bay Native Association, and her job involved traveling. So Patty decided to learn to fly herself in the right position. Here she goes for that river on right there. Blew that ribbon to smithereens out there. All right. 85 with float plane. She earned her commercial and instrument ratings, her seaplane rating, commercial helicopter rating, a flight instructor, and a certified and qualified in many airplanes, including World War II fighters and jets. Patty's sister, Tony, is a pilot and captain for Continental Airlines. But she'd never seen aerobatic flight. A lifelong curiosity led her to attend her first air show in British Columbia in 1983, where she saw aerobatic performance perform and promised herself, I can do that. Patty is trained with the Russian aerobatic team and flown air shows and competitions in such exotic places as South Africa, Russia, Europe, Mexico, and Iceland. She's a member of the Screen Actors Guild, the Motion Pictures Association, and, believe it or not, the United Stunt Women's Association. One of Patty's other accomplishments was the demo pilot for Raytheon, that is now Hawker Beechcraft, military trainer, the T-6AB Texan II, at international air shows such as Paris, Singapore, and Farmington, and continues to coach the T-6 demonstration team. Patty has traveled to East Africa to give bush and recurrency and aerobatic training to pilots of the Kenya Wildlife Service, who protect Kenya's elephants, rhinos, and other natural resources from poachers. And in 2010, Patty started flying for Cal Fire as an air attack pilot flying an OV-1 Bronco. Cal Fire pilots fly both the OV-1 and the S-2T tankers out of 13 different firefighting bases, helping keep Florida safe, or California safe, from fires and supporting firefighters on the ground. Patty continues to take that airplane through its paces here at Robbins Air Force Base. Let me take the opportunity to read off just a few of her accomplishments. A 2007 inductee into International Aviation Hall of Fame. 2006 inductee into the Air Show Hall of Fame. The 2006 Aviation Space Technologies Laureate. The Phil J. Pass Award for lifetime achievement, the 2005 recipient of the Air Force Association's Lifetime Achievement Award, an inductee into the International Aviation Hall of Fame in 2005, the Catherine Wright Award in 2005, the Catherine and Margie Stinson Award, the Bill Barber Award for Air Showmanship, a recipient of the Diploma, an inductee into the Women in Aviation International Hall of Fame, and the list goes on and on. If it can be done in an airplane by a woman, she's won that award. Highly respected on the air show circuit, Penny continues to wow us, even though she has a full-time job fighting wildfires in California. Been cleared to land. Here she comes. No flaps on the X2. She's going to fly the airplane sideways, as you saw. Slipping it. Slowing it down. And here she comes right down on the deck. Time to kick the rudder. Bring the airplane.
Listen to that sound. That's the sound of freedom from 60 years past. Did you notice that short canopy? That razorback fuselage and that red tail. While the airplane gets airspeed and altitude for its first pass, let's talk about the C-Model Mustang's role as the signature aircraft of the Tuskegee Airmen, America's first black military pilot, and why that matters. During the run-up to World War II in the early 1940s, the U.S. Army Corps was under pressure to train black men to be pilots, but the brass doubted they could do it. However, at the direction of President Franklin Roosevelt,